Thank you for tuning in and welcome back to the Sandwich of Coherency. Let's just go ahead and jump right into this. As many of you heard the other day, Joe Biden came out and gave a speech. And we can just go ahead and align that speech along with one of the other mistakes he's had. And this one falls right on the dot with him, as he was before, losing his patience. Well, just listening to it, again, at this point, America is losing its patience. Now, we're going to listen to Senator Mitch McConnell's take, his response, because I want to add my two cents on top of that. Especially considering all this talk of Jim Crow. And I mean, I have to agree on this point with what McConnell says. And it seems to be the case with the Democrats these days. If you disagree with them, well, then you're a racist. You want Jim Crow. You hate black people. And that's even if you are black. I mean, that's the crazy thing about it. If you are Republican and your skin is brown, then that means you hate your people. That is their rhetoric, their ideology. You have to agree with us or you hate yourself. Everything we say is right. Everything they say is bad. Even if we're wrong, we're right. Because we say that we're the party for your people. That's how they want you to be aligned. You know, that's the idea, is that anybody that's a Republican is a white supremacist. And they don't even want people to believe that there are black Republicans, that there are Latino Republicans, that there are Republicans of every race that exist in the United States. And these people have the ability to think for themselves. And it's just, that seems to, like I said, that seems to be the way of the left. If you disagree with them, you are everything under the sun. Racist, sexist, homophobic, transphobic, bigot, prejudice. Every istaphobe they can come up with, you are that. They don't even want to listen to you talk. But, again, we're talking about the idea of this whole Voting Rights Act in this situation with the filibuster and how disagreeing with the Democrats is akin to Jim Crow. If you disagree with them, you want to take the nation back to the era of Jim Crow. That is their argument. So let's go ahead and listen to Mitch McConnell a little bit, and then we'll jump right in here after and a little bit into it.
Uniting our people and uniting our nation. Yesterday, that very same man delivered a deliberately divisive speech that was designed to pull our country further apart. 12 months ago, this president said we should see each other not as adversaries, but as neighbors. Yesterday, he called millions of Americans his domestic enemies. 12 months ago, the president called on Americans to join forces, stop the shouting, lower the temperature. But yesterday, he shouted that if you disagree with him, you're George Wallace. George Wallace. If you don't pass the laws he wants, you're Bull Connor. And if you oppose giving Democrats untrammeled one-party control of the country, well, you're Jefferson Davis. 12 months ago, this president said disagreement must not lead to disunion. Ah, but yesterday he invoked the bloody disunion of the Civil War, to demonize Americans who disagree with him. He compared, listen to this, a bipartisan majority of senators to literal traitors. How profoundly, profoundly unpresidential. Look, I've known, liked, and personally respected Joe Biden for many years. I did not recognize the man at the podium yesterday. American voters did not give President Biden a mandate for very much. He got a tied Senate, negative coattails in the House, the narrowest majorities in over a century. The president did not get a mandate to transform America or reshape society. But he did arguably get a mandate to do just one central thing that he campaigned on. Here's what that was: bridge a divided country, lower the temperature, dial down the perpetual air of crisis in our politics. That is the one central promise that Joe Biden made. It is the one job citizens actually hired him to do. It is the one project that would have actually been consistent with the Congress the voters elected. But President Biden has chosen to fail his own test. The president's rant yesterday was incoherent.
Oh, okay, let me pause right there. I think, let me just go ahead and take this quick, say this real quickly. I think the president's problem is that he hasn't had a sandwich of coherency lately. Thank you. Shameless plug. All right. Let's get back to it.
Incorrect and beneath his office. He used the phrase Jim Crow 2.0 to demagogue a law that makes the franchise more accessible than in his own state of Delaware. He blasted Georgia's procedures regarding local elections officials while pushing national legislation with almost identical language on that issue. The president implied things like widely popular voting ID laws to be, quote, listen to this, totalitarian. Totalitarian. Ironically, on the same day, the Washington, D.C.'s Democratic mayor told citizens to bring both a photo ID and a vaccine card anytime they leave the house.
Yeah, this is it's a bit of a conundrum there, isn't it? They got a bit of a problem, don't they? Don't you need an identification to enter a government building? I mean, maybe not all, I guess. But what if you wanted to go take money out of a bank account? Would you need to have an identification then? What if you wanted to give blood? Is it racist if a store clerk has a 10-year-old obvious child come into their shop to buy cigarettes and a fifth of liquor? Should that store clerk be allowed to ask for identification? Is that not akin to the same general premise here? I know I'm looking, I'm going on both ends of the other spectrum, extreme. I'm, you know, just conflating these things together, but they do fall into the same ballpark. You know, this idea of not believing that people should identify themselves to vote is, I think, it's lunacy. You know, these are absolute, if you look at the climate of politics, if you look at what's going on, how could you not at this point think that, yes, we do need to take even more measures to make sure that the people doing the voting are supposed to be voting, because shit's pretty fucked. I mean, can't be a free for all. I don't know, maybe somebody let me know. Are there any other places in the world where you don't need an identification to vote? You know, where you can vote in their local and governmental elections, federal level, I guess, without needing to identify yourself. I mean, I'm just curious. Maybe that's just me. But again, you know, let's get in this part here. This whole Jim Crow 2.0 thing. And, you know, people do like, they've been saying that for a while now. Now, here's the thing. There was a song called Hotel in Memphis by the Old Crow Medicine Show, which I highly, highly recommend. It is an amazing song. But there is a cover of that song by the band Life Explicit. And in that video, you know, they had, show, it's about the assassination of Martin Luther King. Now, in the video, they have clips and such from that era and during the protests, you know, at Selma and such. Now, you know, you had to sit in here in Greensboro, North Carolina. Now, I'm bringing this up because people keep bringing up Jim Crow 2.0. They keep bringing up Jim Crow. And like I said, they're slinging these words around, not understanding that these words have meaning. Like I said, it's just like slinging, oh, you disagree with me, you're a racist. You disagree with me, you're a Nazi. All this shit. Okay? People keep throwing out Jim Crow. And I highly recommend going and watching that video for that song. For the cover of Hotel in Memphis by Life Explicit, because I don't know, maybe it's me. I'd like, you know, all of you out there listen, maybe I'm just wrong about this. Can someone tell me when the last time the police had police lines where they just said, fuck it, there's black people protesting, and just went and clubbed the shit out of them just to be clubbing the shit out of them? And I'm not talking, don't try with these recent protests where they were burning shit down. No, I'm talking where they were peacefully protesting and they just walked up and just clubbed. Can you compare the shit that was happening in the 50s and the 60s to now? When was the last time they started blasting motherfuckers with water hoses? Chasing them down with lines of German shepherds, like little dog armies. When was the last time that happened? Because I'm still waiting for somebody to tell me where there's a blacks only, whites only water fountain. So, since people want to keep bringing up Jim Crow, let's do a comparison. Let's compare life during that Jim Crow era from the 1880s to the 1960s. Let's see what they were doing then, and let's see where we're at right now. So, let's, we have a law for amateur baseball. Now, what I'm doing is I am actually looking at the National Park Service's website. Okay? NPS.gov. So let's look at these Jim Crow laws. Amateur baseball. For the state of Georgia, it shall be unlawful for any amateur white baseball team to play baseball on any vacant lot or baseball diamond within 2 blocks of a playground devoted to the Negro race. And it shall be unlawful for any amateur colored baseball team to play baseball in any vacant lot or baseball diamond within 2 blocks of any playground devoted to the white race. Is that happening anywhere right now? Can somebody tell me somewhere in the United States where that's happening on any level? Let's have a look at another Jim Crow law. Barbers. For all you people who like to do these TikTok videos, and everybody likes to make the little shorts and the reels and their haircut videos and whatnot. Let's see. No colored barber shall serve as a barber to white women or girls. If we were living in Jim Crow, many of you would be in trouble. Let's see. Bathroom facilities, male. Every employer of white or Negro males shall provide for such white or Negro males reasonably accessible and separate toilet facilities. We got any whites-only colored bathrooms anywhere in the United States? Anywhere? Anybody? Burial. The officer in charge shall not bury or allow to be buried any colored persons upon ground set apart or used for the burial of white persons. Anywhere? In the United States? Child custody. It shall be unlawful for any parent, relative, or other white person in this state, South Carolina, having the control or custody of any white child by right or guardianship, natural or acquired, or otherwise to dispose of, give, or surrender such white child permanently into the custody, control, maintenance, or support of a Negro. Is there anywhere in the United States, that's the case? Let's look at cohabitation. Any Negro man and white woman, or any white man and Negro woman, whom are not married to each other, who shall habitually live in and occupy in the nighttime the same room, shall each be punished by imprisonment not exceeding 12 months, or by fine not exceeding $500. Should I go on? Let's go on a couple. Let's go through a few more. Hospital entrances. Mississippi. Blacks and whites cannot be treated together. They can't enter into the hospital into the same doors. You cannot be seen entering or leaving out of the same doors in a place where they're supposed to be saving your life. Can you tell me anywhere in America where black people can't come in the front door of a hospital? Intermarriage. The marriage of a person of Caucasian blood with a Negro, Mongolian, Malay, or Hindu shall be null and void. Arizona, Florida. All marriages between a white person and a Negro, or between a white person and a person of Negro descent, to the fourth generation inclusive, are hereby forever prohibited. Georgia. It shall be unlawful for a white person to marry anyone except a white person. Any marriage in violation of this section shall be void. Want me to go on? Mississippi. The marriage of a white person with a Negro or mulatto person who shall have 1/8 or more of Negro blood shall be unlawful and void. 1/8 of Negro blood. Missouri, all marriages between white persons and Negroes or white persons and Mongolians are prohibited and declared absolutely void. No person having 1/8 part or more of Negro blood shall be permitted to marry any white person, nor shall any white person be permitted to marry any Negro or person having 1/8 part or more Negro blood. I could go on. Lunch counters, libraries, hospitals for the blind, mental hospitals, militia, mining, nurses, parks, pool and billiard rooms, prisons, job equality, railroads, reform schools, restaurants, teaching, telephone booths, textbooks, theaters, transportation, even wine and beer. Now, you heard just a few of those. That's just a little bit. That's what life was like for people back then. So how dare anybody living now compare themselves to what people were living through back then and what they went through and what they did so we could get to the point as far as we are now. Is it perfect? No. Nothing is perfect by any means. We have a long ways to go, but we have made many leaps and bounds in a short time. In such a very short time. And the crazy thing is that these whole ideas that could be considered in line with Jim Crow come from the Democrats. They're the ones who want separate lunchrooms, separate graduations, separate spaces for races on campuses. You know? They're the ones who, you've been saying it for years. It started during the Obama administration. People, oh, how they so easily forget that Black Lives Matter started in 2013. We've come a long way from Jim Crow. There are people who died and risk their lives so that we could come together as human beings, despite no matter what color we are. And people are mad because the Republicans don't make race the forefront of everything. And Republicans are mad because Democrats make race the forefront of everything. And again, it's always Black people. Oh, it's always racist against Black people. Racist. If you, come on, man. How are you going to say Biden got the most votes? But now you got to fix it because people didn't get to vote. They were cast out. You're not making any sense. Thought the elections were secure. Everything is supposed to be good by your terms. I just don't. The logic, there is none. So yeah, you know, don't compare today to the life that people were living in the 1960s. Don't do that. Do not do that. Do not do them that disservice. Because you take away from what they went through. So yeah, those are just some of the Jim Crow laws. And I want to say those because I want people to think about those, to have those in their mind. Every time people bring that up, you know, ask them, where is there a Jim Crow law being enforced? Let's go fix it. But just saying it does not make it Jim Crow just because you don't like it. But that's our episode. And I thank you for tuning in. And we'll catch you next time.